Today we improve the cooling of the K40 laser cutter and monitor the water temperature and flow rate with an Arduino. The cooling mechanism of the K40 out of the box is actually working quite well. With a large water tank and some cool packs in the water, the laser can cut for maybe 15 to 20 minutes without getting hot. When we created all the parts for our soda bottle rockets, we exceeded this time frame and had to stop several times as the water was getting quite hot. Ideally, it should be around 20 degrees. In order to be able to use the laser cutter a bit longer, we wanted to add an active cooling mechanism. We start with a radiator and three fans used for water cooling desktop computers. The fans are simply screwed on the radiator. We'll link to the product we used in the description. The fans come with connectors that have power on the middle pin and ground on one of the outside pins. You could connect these wires with a wire nut or a WAGO clamp if you don't want to solder. We soldered some pin headers to a piece of perf board, so we can easily swap one of the fans or disconnect it. Power will later be connected to the screw clamp that is also soldered to the perf board. Now let's connect the fans to the laser, the aquarium pump and a flow sensor. The flow sensor is later mounted with a zip tie to the laser cart. We use small hose clamps to connect the existing hose to a flow sensor. The 8mm hose of the flow sensor goes to an adapter. And the 10mm end of the adapter goes to the radiator. Another 10mm hose from the radiator goes to the water reservoir. First, we tried to be smart and cheap and printed the adapter ourselves from a Thingiverse design. This worked somehow. However, for the adapter to be watertight and not break, we had to work with quite some wall thickness. This led to a rather low flow rate. So later we replaced the DIY version with an adapter from eBay and easily doubled the flow rate with the larger diameter. So this is not a place to save $3. We want to mount the fans to the laser card and designed brackets that we cut from MDF. The MDF pieces are glued together with normal wood glue. These brackets are screwed to the radiator and can then be screwed to the card. There will be a separate video on how we designed them in FreeCAD coming soon. To power the fans, we connect one end of the cable to the screw terminal. The other end is connected to the same 12-volt step-down converter we are using for the air assist. Have a look at the air assist video how to install the step-down converter. If you only want cooling, you can consider this project done. We want to take it a step further and monitor the flow rate, the temperature of the water, and get an acoustic warning signal if something is wrong. Here you see the entire set of the electronics on a breadboard. It is only a handful of components that are controlled by an Arduino. The temperature sensor is the cable in the lower left corner, and the flow meter is the small white part connected to the tube. The current values are displayed on an OLED display, and the buzzer signals if the temperature is too high or the flow rate too low. This fritzing sketch, as well as all the very bad code copied from various samples and a list of components, can be found in the written article, link in the description. First, we solder a pin socket for the Arduino Nano and a screw terminal for the power connection to the perf board. We then connect the buzzer with all its connections. Next come four pins for the display. I should really look into PCB design. After the buzzer and the display, we connect two more 3-pin connectors for the temperature sensor and the flow sensor. The cables start to get really messy. Now we add one last resistor and can call it done. The perf board gets a small 3D printed mount. The Arduino can be connected directly to these two terminals that offer 5V. All the cables from the sensors are connected and the power supply is screwed in the terminal on the perf board. The Arduino holder is secured with hot glue to the side of the laser. We cut an opening in the panel with a Dremel tool. Before doing so, we tape styrofoam to the back of the panel so that the metal shavings don't get into the electronics. We carefully break the edges of the opening with a file and then hot glue the panel in place. We can now monitor that the temperature is close to 20 degrees and that the water is flowing. The cooling will allow us to use the laser over longer periods of time. If the video was helpful, please give it a like. To stay up with new videos, please subscribe and follow us on Instagram for a look at future projects.